didn't believe in God at all. They were there watching because my dad in heaven is not a liar. And what is written in this book, he wants us to get a hold of. He wants us to know he's not a liar. He wants us to get bold and stand up and proclaim and be a demonstrator, not a spectator. They got to be a spectator of what God was doing. They already let me in. I did it. They asked me a while back, a few years back, I did a YouTube video in the hospital where I was. Three paraplegics got healed that day in the hospital, and four others walked within 1 year. So seven people walked from that one meeting. Every once in a while, they let me back in, then they banned me for a while. The priest in the hospital. I was in one room praying, and this guy said, "You don't understand." They had doctors, a Russian atheist. Said, "You don't understand." And you hear this Russian accent go, "No, you don't understand. He was way worse than you, and one of the few people ever walk out here." I'd shut up and listen to him. We want to believe in a God that's real. We want to believe in a God. See, I have a friend that I do Sturgis with, and he's an ex-Navy SEAL. He was a medic that went with the SEAL Team 6 all the time, all over the world. And he brought a deal. He said, "This is for you and your wife." And he said, "Expect a miracle. Believe in a bigger God. Don't limit God. Don't limit God. Expect a bigger God. Believe in his miracles." He says, "You make me know that all the time." I love that guy. He goes with me. He's got Jesus big now. I love that he's out. He's working on becoming a doctor. He's working as a nurse now. I can't wait to see, but what he does in Jesus is incredible. My question is, are you a mountain mover? Are you a demonstrator? Are you going to be a spectator? Are you going to step back? Are you going to tell the devil, I just don't receive this anymore?
Yeah.
I am not going to receive these limits, the sickness on me that stops me from doing what I'm going to do. I'm going to go forward and do it. So you're going to start speaking to your mountains and saying, "Get off, get out."
Amen.
You're going to tell sickness, "Sickness, go. I ain't going to that house. No, you go. Sickness is going to be back down the street going, no, you go. Come on, illness. I tried that. That place there, they kicked my tail. I am the..." And see broken bones just healed up. I'll just tell you a few more stories. Can I brag God a little bit?
Yeah.
There's a group of kids. They knew someone that was, he was a wrestler. He was wrestling for the state tournament. And he pinned a guy, but he broke his wrist. So I know a bunch of crazy Christian kids. They say, "I'm going to take care of it, Ron. He's got that. God will take care of it." So God heals the boy's wrist. And he goes back and wins the championship the next night. You go see. You go see God moving. You go see where sickness is left. You go start praying in the hospital and watch all the monitors get better. The oxygen level goes up. I love going to children's hospitals and praying and watching all the monitors go up and their heartbeats get better. See, we infect the world. The world does not infect us. In Oklahoma City, I went in. There was a guy having a massive heart attack. And the family asked me to go in. I was visiting back there, doing some ministry. I go in the hospital. His heart attack stopped. They were expecting him to die any second. He has no signs of heart attack. God heals his heart. Everyone in that wing, it started changing so much. So they come and they have me handcuffed because they're looking for electronic devices on me. Because every room we walk by, the healing power of God was on us. So I got news for you. Where I was in the hospital, 10 people were supposed to die. But I got all these crazy Christian friends, like them four Christian friends that carry that prayer. Guess what? They prayed for everybody, and all 10 people supposed to die, they all got healed. God just didn't heal me. When his healing power came, he got us all. When the healing power of God falls in you, you walk through the hospital, you can see it on the monitors. You can see you're not walking alone. A friend called me up and said, "Did you make it home from Sturgis?" I go, "Yeah, I had three in the truck with me." He goes, "What do you mean? Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. They were with me the whole way. I always travel with three extras. I don't travel alone." I can't even tell you that. Do you know the outlaw bikers? Like the Hells Angels, the Sons of Silent, the Mongols, they wanted to shut me up from going to all the biker ministry, so they studied my story. You know what happened? They nicknamed me the Dead Man. They call me the Dead Man now. They go, "His story's crazy, but it's true. That dude really died. He was declared dead, and he's alive now." So they just call me the Dead Man and honor it. They couldn't disprove me and shut me up. So now they honor it and tell everyone, "You need to hear the story at least once." So they invite all the outlaw bikers, have an in that they can come, because they get in trouble if they come to an event without permission. And they gave permission for any biker to come to one of my events just to hear about Jesus Christ. And they bring people all the time. And We're seeing so many people. One crazy outlaw biker, just maybe 3 years ago, he brought in his son that was hit by a drunk driver, 21. Guy's a major drug dealer, crazy man, brings in his son because he has nothing for his son that's all paralyzed. He said, you're going to share Sturgis this year? I said, Wednesday night. This year we did it. Saturday night, changed up some. And they brought it in, and they laid him at my feet. And I told my story. In the middle of my story, that kid got it, and he got up completely healed from him. He was riding all night round. You can't see him screaming, I'm healed, I'm healed. Rode all night just screaming at the top of his lungs how that God had healed him from being paralyzed. You want to see a God that's real? Dad said, I got nothing, but he needs to hear your story. Maybe get my son up. And God healed his son. He just said, I don't care if he's a drug dealer. I want to touch that family. Yeah. I want him to get saved.
Come on.
You don't think his dad stands up? Someone says something bad about me? Ooh. See, the thing is, when you go work with real power and real things, years back, they had starving kids at one camp that the Hells Angels run. They brought them starving kids and said, you got to help us, man. We don't want Child Protective Services out here. One boy, he had fallen. I'm going to tell a few more stories. But this boy had fallen. There were family that chased the Grateful Dead around. And there were dreadlocks and the whole thing. This little blondie boy, he was about 6 years old and he had dreadlocks. And he was running that day and he fell. And he put his teeth all the way through his lip and all the way through there. And he had all these stitches there, and he bit his tongue enough that his tongue was stitched up. And so I went over to get this family. I had to borrow an SUV because I'm on a bike there. I borrowed an SUV, and as I went there to pick them up, then this boy showed me this. And so we made all this food for kids and got a box of food for them for the family to take back. And Dad didn't want to come, but all the kids came. And here's this little boy, and we made all this food for him. And I said, Nugget was his name. They named him Nugget. So I said, little Nugget, you want some food? And he goes, I can't, man. It's too sore. My tongue's too swollen up. And I turn around, I got tears in my eyes. I said, isn't that just like a punk of Satan? Here's this starving kid who made all this food and he can't eat now. That's a Satan deal. And so I kind of got together and see him crying. I turned around and said, Nugget, would it be okay if I prayed for you? He goes, okay. I said, if you feel better, you come and you tug on me because I got other people we got to feed. So we fed this, like this year, it was about 700 to 900 every day we fed. So he come and he tugged on my deal. About 5 minutes later, I get this tug on my leather vest, and I turn around, there's Nuggets. The stitches are gone. His tongue swelling's gone. God completely healed this little guy. And he's like, he ate 4 plates of food. He was so hungry. And I'm just bawling because God was so good. And they remember taking him back to their camp. He goes, look, mister, it still doesn't hurt. You know, that can never be stolen. His whole life, he's going to know. He said, what happened? I said, you met your heavenly father. And he's so much better than anything you can imagine. And God just wanted to love on that family. See, I'm telling you, that's the kind of God we got. Amen. Kind of God said, we got bullets. So go with bullets. Don't go screaming blanks and just making a bunch of noise. But go with bullets and shoot them. My favorite thing I want to do is I want to get to heaven and have the Lord tell me, good thing you came in today. You had no bullets. You used them all. I didn't want one bullet left I could have shot.
Right.
I want them all gone. That's I want right. Empty magazines when I get to heaven. Amen. I want to have shot everything that God gave me to shoot. So they're just some incredible things of God. I see him move, and I see him move in there. And I can just tell you that it's not about special people. It's about a special God moving through ordinary people. And his love. If you don't go in his love, don't go. Because it's his fiery love going through us.
Yes.
That's been getting all over Lydia, man. She's been getting that. She's been getting that fiery love. She's been boiling out of her. You hug her and it's like a sponge of God's love gets on you. The fiery love of God's been getting on her.
Praise God.
And I'm telling you that today, I'm just going to pray if that'd be all right. Would that be all right?
Yeah.
I could tell you miracles, just recent miracles that were just, were people going in just the other day, someone asked us to pray. The wife was going to San Francisco, the doctor had already checked her, the specialist looked at her, the heart was so bad, they weren't even sure she'd live. She got to San Francisco, they sent her back and said, what tests were you guys looking at? The doctors came back and they couldn't find anything wrong with her. That's the kind of God we serve.
Yeah.
The kind of God that says, I got this. So See, when we understand we got the God, I got this, I got your back, and it's not depending on you. If it's depending on you, it's like getting rid of the mountains with a shovel and a pick. When it's depending on Him, He does it.
Amen.
So, Lord, I thank You that You're an awesome God. I thank You that You're bigger than anything I could talk about.
Yes.
I thank You that You're the kind of God that answers prayers. You hear and You answer prayers. I pray that today people will leave here knowing that You're a bigger God and You want to move through them. You want to do a demonstration of Your power through each and every one in here. And I ask You to make demonstrators out of them.
Yes,
let Your demonstration, Your power, and Your fiery love shoot out of us. Thank You, God. Let those that need to hear a word about You come and be drawn into each one of us now. So we pray for Your healing power that sickness and disease get out of this room.
Yes.
Yeah, get out of these people. Yes. They have no place in them. By the mighty name of Jesus, we lay the stripes upon each one, each sickness, each pain, even the pain here, out of here. You've been way too long. Released. Get out. Let Your light and life go. Let Your forgiveness and Your love flow in a more mighty way. Give us eyes to see the answer before the problems even get to us. Give us those kind of eyes. And let us concentrate on what You're doing. Let's get our eyes off the distraction and get our eyes on the prize of what You're doing. We pray for this and we pray for Your mighty moves now. In Jesus' name, Shua HaMashiach. Bless You. Thank You very much. I'm going to believe for Jesus to do it. I'm going to tell you, just if you believe you got sickness on, just tell you, you're not welcome here. If you got illness, tell you got cancer, say cancer, get off me. I don't receive you anymore. It just works. It just works because Jesus took that cancer upon Himself. So it has no legal right to be on you. If you got joint pains, if you need cartilage to grow back, then start saying, I just command this. Jesus took a stripe so that cartilage can grow back in my leg, or my back, or my hips. See, I shouldn't be able to walk around. My muscles still aren't connected together, and God just makes them work. I don't know. I don't even want to know most of it, to tell you the truth. I'm just glad He's bigger than that. At one point, I just go, that's like total overload. I'm just glad God's bigger than that. My heartbeat, you know, if they put an EKG on me, I have the heartbeat of a man having a massive heart attack. But my blood pressure's fine. I do construction. I got a ranch to work on. I don't have any problems because God's bigger. Whatever you got today, God is bigger. Not because of me, because He took it upon Himself. He took it upon Him. He paid the price. He paid the price to heal your cancer. He paid the price to take your pain. He paid the price to take your emotional pain.
Yes.
He paid the price. He paid the price. And it's time we see our prayers answered in the name of Jesus. So thank You, Lord. God's in here right now. God's calling. Just raise up your hand.
Amen.
Say thank You, God. Just receive what He's pouring out. The angels are pouring out over here. I just see an open heaven and the angels pouring out. Just receive. 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 There's health and wholeness in here. There's emotional healing going on there.
There is.
There's finances coming for those who've been blocked. In Jesus' name, let the finances roll forth. Oh, thank You. There's a release of some vehicles to people that need vehicles. There's a release of things coming that God says some stuff has been held back, but the enemy's been caught. It's been slapped down by some angels. Some more angels. There's a release. And sickness and disease and health problems. You just got to leave. All of it. You're just not welcome. The immune system, rise up. Rise up the immune system and bring healing and health.
Yes.
Immune systems can heal cancer. That's what God gave to heal. So cause them to rise up and work right and chase cancer cells out. May blood counts come back right on everybody in there. All the blood counts come back right. Perfect amount of red and white cells. All cancer cells just gone and dissolved from the body and get out in Jesus' name. Hopelessness, get out of here. You're not welcome to anyone in here. Hopelessness, you're broken. You are our hope, and You are enough. I pray to break lies that have lied over you. I I pray for lying spirits that have been assigned to some people that are speaking into their ears constantly. You're broken and you're sent back to the pits of hell. And they'll hear your voice. They'll hear your truth. They'll see your eyes. The scales are falling off to see your answers. Thank you for that. I thank you for moving on hearts today. We just love your presence, God. Your presence just flowing with love. We ask you bless that mightily. Just let us feel you and know you.
Yes.
Just hang with you. To know you're our daddy and you welcome us and with you. You aren't trying to hold us back or tell us you're too busy. You're just waiting for us. You're omnipresent. You ask and we ask and you're already there. You show us that. That's all you do. You open our eyes to see you are there before we even ask. I thank you for that. I thank you that this will be a group that sees your answer before the problem makes it to their door. They'll be so focused on the answer that they'll see the answer coming before the problem. That's funny because I already see how God's being now. There's going to be laughter in this story. Laughter, laughing at the problems of the enemy. He's going to be that little mouse with a megaphone and a big old lion looking deal, a monster looking deal in front. When it falls over, it's going to be a mouse back there with a loudspeaker. You just step on it and go over it. Because that's the power of the devil. To hear that much greater. We thank you that we hear your voice and your voice only. And we'll move by your voice. And you'll start showing people a Holy Spirit GPS exactly how to lead them. They say, walk 300 feet, now turn left here. Okay, two steps here, turn right here. It'd be that clear that we'd see you through the Holy Ghost that clear. The Holy Ghost, we still welcome you to move and do your thing. You do your thing. We just welcome you. We thank you. You are the teacher. We thank you, Lord. You are the healer. You come with healings in your wings and chase out anything that's bugging us. Feet problems. I just see feet problems. Half to leave. Feet problems. Back problems. Joint problems. Leave. Arthritis, doctors, the things doctors have been saying, we break the power of the doctor's words because they're only seen in the natural. So break their power and release your life and light in that situation. Thank you for that. Thank you that we're going to speak your hope in your words. Thank you that your words that you've written for us will come alive in us. No longer be dead words, but alive words that come out of us. We'll speak your words out in such a way they come out with fire and love and they get on us. And they get in us, and they're just part of us because you speak them out of us. We thank you that you are a depositor, and we are demonstrators because of the deposit of you inside of us. We thank you that you'll show us that more and more now. In Jesus' mighty name, Lord. Eyes that work better, eyes that work better, minds that are sharper. All the fogs and minds got to get out in Jesus' name. Mind fogs, God. We have the mind of Christ, a perfect mind. So we thank you for that now, in Jesus' name. I thank you for kids that come back to the Lord. Kids, just like that lady. Even when she's gone, you showed her son getting saved. That there's people been praying for kids and spouses. And have seen nothing. That your word has gone forth and you've heard their word. And they will be delivered. In Jesus' name. Thank you for that. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. And I just see some that are crying out for work and jobs that they come forth now in Jesus' name. The holdbacks are broken down. They're going to run right through that wall. They're going to step through a wall that looked like an impenetrable wall. And it's going to be nothing there anymore. Thank you for that in Jesus' name. Glory to you, Lord. We thank you're an awesome God. What an awesome daddy, and you are not a liar. Thank you for that. Thank you that your word is the most sure thing in this universe. Thank you, Lord. Pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for letting me share. Thank you. Awesome. I just pray you get to be like my wife and I. We're little kids on an adventure with our daddy a lot. And I pray you guys get that same deal.
Amen.
We're like little kids on an adventure with your dad.